Hello, I'm Jamie Newberry. It's day two of 31 random adventures, and I'm working from home today. So I figured if we're not going to be out adventuring outside my house, the least I could do is try to make it something useful. So today we're going to talk about list making. If I'm productive in any way, it's because I make lists. And so I'm just going to talk a little bit about how I go about list making. And if you make lists, if you're a list maker, I would love to hear how you go about making lists and what sort of little tips and tricks you have, because I'm always interested in learning how other people do it and trying new things and trying new ways. So I have tried just about every to-do list and app, digital realm list maker there is out there, and nothing has really ever stuck with me the same way that just writing it on paper does. So a habit I got into back when I was a park ranger is we had these little blank books, and we would write every day a list of like 15 things, and we would hack through them, and we had routines and things that we did, and then, you know, occasionally new things that would drop into our day to day. So I kind of took that habit and I've run with it. And I buy blank journals. I give it my own title, Things to Do. Very clever, right? And with that, I populate the pages within. And I do a lot of private client work, so I'm not going to show you specific lists, but I'm going to tell you how I break it out. So I do these just for my work stuff. Household stuff, I have different lists that go on the back of doors in each room with tasks to do. We'll do a whole thing on house to-dos some other time down the road. But what I do for my work stuff is I break it into two categories, things I'd like to do and things I have to do. And each list at any given time has probably 20, 25 things on it. And I work directly from those lists, I draw from them, but I break them down every day into something a little bit smaller. It has to fit on a sticky note, and usually that's three things. So here's an example I made of what I'm working on today. I had a client call this morning, and then I had to send an invoice to that same client, so that's a thing I did. I have two more things to check off the list, and that's kind of how I get things done. I break them into smaller pieces so it's not this big, overwhelming, daunting list. And once I do that, I feel like I get a lot of stuff done. Occasionally, I actually get all three things done and I create another list of three things, and that can roll over into tomorrow. If I don't get things done and I have a sneaking suspicion that I'm only going to get the next one done on this list, and the third one might have to roll over until tomorrow. So we'll see how it goes. Hopefully I get it done. But that's how I break things out in my list making, and that's how I stay productive. I hope that's a helpful tip. And again, I would love to hear your helpful list making tips if you have any. It would be awesome. So that's it. That's all I've got. That's my random adventure for today, is list making. And I hope to see you tomorrow for day three. Subscribe if you're not already subscribing, and I'll see you tomorrow.